Hello everyone, I am Innypride and welcome to the city of Altdorf, the crown jewel and seat of the Empire's power. The Imperial Colleges of Magic are an incredibly important component of this famous city, founded by Loremaster Teclis of the High Elves, an institution that has stood against the corrupting influence of chaos since the reign of Magnus the Pious. The University of Altdorf is home to the most well-respected scholars and thinkers in the Old World, and across the street stand the mighty walls of the Reichsfort. Training ground for the Reichsguard, the heavy cavalry bodyguards of the Emperor, and currently under the watchful eye of the Supreme Patriarch of the Colleges of Magic, and guarded by a steam tank, one of only eight in existence. Past the university, the Brayherd of Khazrak the One-Eye have torn down the stone walls in the midst of their primal fury, and Boris Todbringer and the Army of Middleland will attempt to stem the tide of beasts in that plaza, but with minotaurs and giants in the mix, that will be brutal work indeed. As we cross the confluence of the rivers Reich and Talabek, we get a great look at the Imperial Palace, home of Karl Franz, Elector Count of Reichland, and the Emperor of Man. Very defensible and fortified position there. Even for the forces of Chaos, that might be a difficult nut to crack indeed. Swinging by the Grand Temple of Sigmar and into the Dwarf Quarter, where merchants and stonemasons ply their trade. As we shift past that beautiful building, towards the middle of the city as a final fallback position should everything go south, and hopefully it won't, across the bridges that span the rivers, we've got the Reichsport, the harbor, and the slums of the inner city, where Volkmar the Grim and his forces will stand in reserve should the Colleges of Magic, Imperial Palace, and the inner plazas fall to the tides of chaos. This is a 4v4 siege battle on BennyMclennan's map of Altdorf, and it is a really good battle. So stick around, let's get into it. Hordes of Chaos Undivided pouring through the breaches in the walls of Altdorf. Chaos Marauders in the front lines getting raffle stomped by Mortars and Hellstorm Rocket Batteries as they pour through. It's going to be tough going for the Forces of Chaos early on. This is why you send Meat Shields first to soak up some of that fire from the artillery. Aspiring Champions behind them to give them some morale bonus as they move into melee. Won't be enjoying that combat with Greatswords, but that's what they're there for. Soak up the charge bonus of those armor-piercing bonus for infantry units and allow the Forsaken and the rest of the Chaos forces to move into melee. They are getting shredded by mortars from the Imperial Palace right now, though, and some of the Chaos Manticores have actually gone straight for the mortars up on the battlements. Try and take them out quickly, but Karl Franz, the Emperor of Man, and Deathclaw, his Imperial Griffin, will be able to make short work of those Manticores. So they'll be running now for now. Don't know if they'll be able to get away from Karl Franz, but believe they should be able to relatively easily. And an Exalted Hero making those great swords run for the hills, and I don't blame them. This is a lot to expect from your great swords. So many Forsaken and Chaos Giants pouring through the breach right now. They're getting hammered by those mortars. Here come the Chaos Knights and a lot of the other terrifying beasts of Chaos Undivided. There are two Beastmen players and two Chaos Undivided players on the field right now. Looks like Chaos will be attacking from this side of the battlefield. A lot of Chaos Knights roaring past the Dwarf Quarter and Grand Temple of Sigmar, but something special is waiting to greet them. Three of the eight steam tanks still in existence have been mobilized for the city's defense. In Warhammer lore, it wasn't the last Empire city to fall, but it was the most important, being in the capital and where Karl Franz made his home. They'll spare no expense to try and keep it in allied hands. Nice shot from the steam tank, and those Chaos Knights are in a dangerous spot. Demigriff Knight circling in from the front and from behind could get a beautiful hammer and anvil off on that group of Chaos Knights if they're not careful. They are seeking to disengage. The Royal Altdorf Griffites coming in from the flank and getting ready to slam into the unprotected flank of the Chaos Knights, and they don't want any of that action. Armor piercing and bonus versus large will rip them in half, especially because they didn't get their charge bonus off. So they're going to pull away, try to put some distance in between them and the Griffs, and Steam Tank will give them a parting gift as they pull away from that engagement. Let's take a look at BennyMclennan and the forces of Khazrak, the One-Eye, his Brayherd pouring through the breach right now, and Benny's Middleland forces will be looking to stem the tide there. Tons of Minotaurs on the field, lots of Bestigors and Ungors, Razor Gore herd, some chariots, Gorbul to anchor the line, and a giant. That is going to be some serious firepower on this part of the battlefield. Can the cannons and the Empire Halberdiers and Spearmen hold the line for Ulrich and for the Empire? That is going to be a tough fight. And this is one of those siege layouts that I absolutely adore. Lots of famous areas to fight over inside the city, very mindful of lore and recreating Altdorf to its maximum potential, but not sacrificing anything in terms of gameplay. Has a ton of open space and brutal choke points that we can utilize, and we're making use of the entire city instead of just a few parts of it. Makes for way more cinematic and strategic battles. Love making these kind of videos on well-designed maps. Boris and his Imperial Griffin are gonna paint the plaza crimson with some Ungor blood. Things are about to get messy for both sides. Oh yeah, that was beautiful. Crosswomen raining fire into the unarmored front ranks, and Empire Spearmen rallying to their lord around Boris and his Imperial Griffin. Ungor herd coming into charge as well, and the cannons are just pouring in a ton of fire against those minotaurs. You see a bunch of them getting knocked down in the background. This is terrifying. Charge coming in now. Oh, it's gonna be brutal. And cannon shot going through the flank of those minotaurs, knocking down a couple of them. Beautiful, but lucky shot. And I think that might just piss them off more than they already were. I wouldn't want to be an Empire State Troop face to face with an angry herd of minotaurs. Not a good place to be. Probably about to make their peace with Ulrich. And here comes the Beastmen Giant, who is getting wrecked by that same cannon fire as the great swords mobilize and try to surround it. If this was tabletop, that giant would probably already be dead with all that cannon fire coming in, crossbows stunlocking him, but he is still alive and into the great swords and probably about to lay down the hammer. Great swords do not want to be fighting a Beastmen Giant. Oh, look at that. Unlucky guy slammed into the ground, and now he is a red pancake in the dust. Not a fun way to go, but the University of Altdorf is holding out here. Handgunners firing in from the flank, but the forces of Morghur the Shadowgave from the North Gate are pouring through, and it looks like Gelt and his forces have had to retreat to the Reichsfort. Minotaur is trying to chase down the steam tank. Not going to be able to kill it too easily, but they do have armor piercing, so he's going to have to pull out of that pretty quickly. And Morghur's forces and the Beastmen are looking to engage with Balthasar Gelt at the Reichsfort very soon. Let's take a look as we cross the River Reich at Karl Franz in the Imperial Palace, see how his defense is going. They've got a real nice position there. Mortars and Hellstorm rocket batteries firing into a bunch of Forsaken who are ascending the hill towards that massive grand statue of Sigmar. Karl Franz and Deathclaw on Overwatch above, and here comes a Comet of Cassandora from above. Oh, this could be beautiful. Chaos Giant moving up as well. Forsaken blobbing up pretty hard here. Comet roaring from above, slamming into the Forsaken and jibbing a bunch of them. Beautiful use of that spell. Don't get to see it very often. Not sure how many kills it got because it doesn't actually count on the kill counter for the Celestial Wizard, unfortunately. But that was beautiful. That killed a lot of Forsaken, it looked like, and is going to start sending them running away. They'll probably mobilize soon, but for now, going to cause them to rout from the terror from Karl Franz and Deathclaw as well. Minotaurs trying to push through these Empire Halberdiers who are backed up by the steam tank, and the Lore of Life, Jade Wizard, is above them, keeping them in the fight for now. Halberds aren't the best choice to heal, but if the steam tank and some of these other units, I guess the Warrior Priest of Sigmar on a barded warhorse could also get healed by that as well. Could be a good use of the spell. Minotaurs are going to rip through that front line, though, backed up by the Ungor. It's going to be a tough fight. Not sure they'll be able to push back those forces. And some Minotaurs have made it into the Empire. Great swords. Oh, look at that. Wow, that was awesome. Knocking down a big chunk of the unit there with their AoE attacks. And the forces of Midland and Boris are getting pushed back and overwhelmed by the Brayherd of Khazrak the One-Eye. Minotaurs, Ungor herd, Bestigors, and Gore herd pushing through, and Harpies flying above as well. So Boris is going to pull back and regen some of that health with his Midland Runefang. And I am still in reserve. I am playing Volkmar the Grim and the forces in the slums in the back of the city waiting to be utilized later on. I haven't seen too much that might require me to pull my Empire State Troops out of the slums and the harbor to go reinforce somewhere else on the battlefield. We do want a fallback position, and that will be where we mobilize at the end of the game if everything goes south. But with that said, I can still use my cavalry to its fullest potential. My Demigriff Knights with Halberds and the Royal Altdorf Griffites will come in to reinforce the Reichsfort and Balthasar Gelt. Light Wizard with the Net of Amontok going to tie down a bunch of the Minotaurs and the Bestigors that are moving in. And here come the Royal Altdorf Griffites and the Demigriff Knights with Halberds with that beautiful shot of the Colleges of Magic in the background. That is so cool. That is so Warhammer right there. Nice charge coming in into the Minotaurs, but there are some reinforcements backing them up, and the Gorbul is wading into combat as well. Mortars opening up, and a little bit of friendly fire, unfortunately, but probably doing more damage to the Beastmen than anything else. Morghur the Shadowgave with his chaotic taint just spilling out behind him and beneath his feet. And I'm going to have to pull my Demigryph Knights out of there. I was looking to take out the Minotaurs with an End of Amentok, tie them down, and allow my armor-piercing and bonus first large to go to work against them. But I was a little bit slow, and the Beastman Morghur player did a good job reinforcing, making sure that I couldn't do too much damage to those Minotaurs on that front. Over here, we've got some Empire Halberdiers making their last stand against a bunch of Chaos Marauders. Brutal close-quarters combat going on right now. Blood spilling everywhere. And Harpies crossing the river, looking for a flanking opportunity to maybe get into some of our squishy targets, like the handgunners that are conglomerating near the bridge. And that is another thing about this map that I think is absolutely gorgeous. There are a lot of bridges to fight over, and bridges are always a very tactically interesting place to fight, because especially when you got line of sight across the river, you can fire in from multiple angles and do some really cool stuff with your cavalry around those areas. Reichsfort is on its last legs. Gelt is still alive. Jade Wizard and the Steam Tank are still alive. But Morghur's forces are looking to assault one last time and put the nail in their coffin for good. Even a Chaos Giant waiting to wade into melee as well, backed up by Gorbul. But Morghur and his Bestigor herd are doing something else. This is interesting. They're pulling up the main street, the main road in the center of Altdorf, and they are pushing on towards the Midland forces, trying to slam into the flank and maybe get at those handgunners that are around, and crossbows that are around the bridge. My Demigryph Knights are waiting for them, though. Harpies coming in. Looks like they're routing, actually. Routing past the Midland forces, and handgunners will be getting some good shots in there. It's a little bit wonky. There are some hitboxes and stuff where a tower will not block shots of a handgunner. We try to turn our stuff off fire at will so that doesn't happen too often. But Bestigors slamming into the flank and decapitating a bunch of those handgunners. Here come my Demigryph Knights and the Reichsguard, bodyguards of Karl Franz. And we are just pancaking those Bestigors, slamming into them from both flanks. But Morghur the Shadowgave has summoned some Chaos Spawn behind my Demigryphs. That is a nice position for them to be in. Could get a rear charge off, but I have my Royal Altdorf Griffites close by as well. And have Amentok to prevent the charge bonus from those Chaos Spawn and their high weapon damage going off into the back of my Demigryphs. And that will allow my Royal Altdorf Griffites to overlap the engagement and cut them to pieces. So that could have been dangerous, but with the handgunners firing in, good use of Net of Amentok, those Chaos Spawn will fall and disintegrate very quickly. Got Gelt down in the center of the gate here. Steam Tank knocking a bunch of Minotaurs around all willy-nilly, just knocking them into the side of the Reichsfort. And Gelt does not want to be fighting a bunch of Minotaurs in melee. That could be very dangerous for him. Handgunners firing into Morghur. Boris Todbringer landing on his head as well. And here comes some Centaurs with great weapons. That would normally be a scary cav fight, but with two Demigryph Knights with Halberds charging headlong into them, I will rip them a new one. Armor piercing, not the biggest deal, because Centaurs, of course, don't have much armor, but that bonus first large and high weapon strength will cut them to pieces. And very quickly, those Centaurs will run. And I will keep the pressure on them, make sure they don't come back and rejoin the battlefield. We'll get a good look at the bridges that cross over to the slums of Altdorf. The harbor area is a beautifully created area of this map. Boris Todbringer and Karl Franz are overseeing the engagement, but it does look like the forces of Midland are beginning to collapse. There are a lot of high-strength troops from the Beastmen and from Morghur who are now moving in from the flank that are overwhelming the forces of the Empire. Vileside going off in the street, and Khazrak and a Gorbul and looks like a Bray Shaman are moving through the streets now and charging into the flank, sending a bunch of Empire troops flying, and Chaos Knights pouring across the bridge as well and into the flank of the Midland and Empire forces. And things are starting to look very bad for the Empire. Manticore into the back of some greatswords, ripping them apart, eviscerating them, and painting the cobblestone red. Wow, but here come the Hellstorm Rocket Battery shots from the flank. That's all the way from the Imperial Palace. Look at that, that's a beautiful sight. Artillery slamming into the flank of some Bestigors, doing a lot of damage. That is getting shot from so far away. That is so cool looking. bunch of those Bestigors are falling to that artillery, and it does look like a few survivors at the Imperial Palace have made it and pushed back the forces of Chaos, who are now mobilizing at the bridges, looking to cross and get into the slums of Altdorf. Handgunners opening up fire, steam tank, and the Hellblaster Volley Gun have been doing some damage to those Chaos Knights as well. And they are going to be crossing the bridge now. Powerful heavy cavalry and getting shredded by the handgunners and a steam tank shot. Oh, that was beautiful. But they are going to get across and get a charge into the flagellants, who will not be able to brace. Not that it would have done them much good anyway. Get into the handgunners as well. That'll do a lot of damage. But those Chaos Knights are beaten up. They have taken a lot of damage from the steam tank that was firing across the River Reich. And there's some more Chaos Marauders and Chaos Forces moving into position as well. Focus on that in a bit. But for now, let's look at Midland. What do they have left? Almost nothing. Getting shredded apart and munched on by the Beastmen. And now I'm going to have to start committing my forces. We've got Benny's Hellblaster Volley Gun firing in from the flank. And the Light Wizard with that of Amatok is still looking where he can be most of use. Those Chaos Knights will route to the terror caused by the steam tank. And there's some Halberds on this side. Actually, Chaos Warriors, the Great Weapons, looking to close into melee, where they will easily deal with many of the Empire State Troops 1v1. But look at those shots from the handgunners. Oh, ripping them apart. Net of Amentok too. That is going to be a nice combination. This is why I love bringing the net, and only the net, on the Light Wizard. It is so powerful being able to just completely immobilize a unit and allow a handgunner or an artillery crew to just rip them apart. And those Chaos Warriors are taking so much damage. Each one of those volleys doing about 1,000 HP damage to the Chaos Warriors with Great Weapons. And they will be able to cross, but not before a bunch of their number are cut to pieces by the powerful gunpowder units of the Empire. So I'll pull my handgunners back. Look at those Chaos Warriors. Already down to half strength. Sigmar's Sons and the Flagellants will move into melee, probably backed up by some Greatswords. And the cannons are firing into the Chosen with Halberds. They're looking to cross the bridge as well. And look at those Chaos Warriors already wavering before they even made it into melee. And Flagellants and Sigmar's Sons both being unbreakable, not going to have a good time there. Forces of Chaos are going to struggle to break through for the moment. But they are certainly winning the battle. They have taken control of much of Altdorf at this point. Boris is on his last legs, barely any HP left. He'll have to pull back to the slums, and the Reichsfort is about to fall as well. Razorgore Herd are chewing through these great swords, but the Beastmen don't even have to take it, honestly. They could just kill the remainder of these great swords, then pull out and go for another target, because mortars and crossbowmen are not going to be able to reinforce very easily, and if they do leave the safety of the Reichsfort, they will be ridden down by the Beastmen and the forces of Chaos Undivided. It looks like they're beginning their next stage of their assault, although there's not a whole lot of power in the Chaos troops that are looking to cross right now. Almost no HP among them. And they will be first into melee. Aspiring champions aspiring to be given a glorious death, apparently. Ruinous powers do not look kindly upon failure, and with such little HP left among them, failure seems pretty likely here. They are going to charge into the flagellants and take down a few before they go. But I think pretty soon here, Khorne's going to turn them into Chaos Spawn for sucking, because they're not going to be around for too much longer. That first attack seems doomed, but with the Empire forces of Midland and Reichland faltering across the bridge, things are definitely starting to look a little bit dangerous. But on this side, the steam tank, Volkmar the Grim, have slaughtered some Chosen. And the War Chariot, the War Altar of Sigmar, and Volkmar the Grim, the Grand Theogonist of the Cult of Sigmar, will make sure that those Chosen of the Dark Gods do not return. Some Marauders getting jibbed by a cannon. Beautiful shots as always. And those first Great Weapon Chaos Warriors look like they're going to rout pretty soon here. Handgunners firing into the flank of some Chosen with Halberds. And Volkmar is noticing something here. There is a big blob of Chaos Warriors with Halberds fighting at the bridge, dealing with the Flagellants and the Sigmar's Sons. Steam tank chugging along, getting ready to come in from behind and maybe get a nice rear charge off, maybe get a couple nice shots in. What is that? That is a banishment. The vortex spell from the Lore of Life onto a huge group of Chaos Warriors. And look at that HP bar drop. That was like 3/4 HP left on those Halberds. and then suddenly wavering, and that's only because they were so blobbed up on the bridge. Man, that was a beautiful vortex pill. Don't get to see that used very often and kill a lot of troops, but that is going to cause the entire group of Chaos Warriors on this side to rout and right into the jaws of the waiting steam tank. We'll then plow through them and rip them apart on the bridge. Oh, that was beautiful. That was orgasmic, I must say. That felt so good when I pulled that one off in the game. But it is not even close to being the end or the nail in the coffin for the forces of Chaos. Preventing them from remobilizing is going to be tough, and they still have so many troops. Look at the balance bar. Still very much in the favor of Chaos and the Beastmen, but we do have a very strong defensive position at this point in the battle. So the Beastmen and the forces of Chaos are just mobilizing, getting all their troops together, and getting ready for the final assault. I think it was a mistake for them to send a couple of those units across the bridge unsupported. Would have been better off if they held back and waited till everything was ready. But with that said, they still have so many troops on the field, it might not even matter. Don't get to see these Hellblaster volley guns very often. Their ammunition, or their shots per volley, have actually been doubled in the last patch. They now shoot 18 shots instead of 9 per volley, which doesn't double their damage output really, but it is a significant boost to their damage output. And so that thing can actually do some serious damage in a situation like this when it's not on the open field, when you can protect it better with the natural geography that we have in the map, like the River Rike that is now separating the forces of Chaos and our artillery. Crosswomen firing in to the flank of some Marauders and sending them to the earth dead. Minotaurs and some Chaos Warriors getting ready to cross as well. So you can see there are a lot of troops still on the field for the forces of Chaos. It is going to be a tough fight. When this match started, there were 5,000 troops on the field for both sides, much less now for both teams. Chaos Knights with lances charging into some crossbowmen and Empire artillery crew. I don't think those crossbows are going to be making out of that combat alive. Chaos Knights have been beaten up, but beating up crossbows is not particularly hard. Shifting over the Dwarf Quarter, we can still see more forces straining through, getting ready to cross the bridge. And you can see my forces as well. I have great swords at each gate. Sigmar's Sons and the Flagellants, who have taken some damage, and the Demigryphs and Steam Tank are getting ready to pull back and go to the other side of the field where they'll be most needed. Volkmar the Grim still at full HP and of course has that regeneration as well, so not expecting to lose him anytime soon. And thankfully, we do have a trick up our sleeve here. We have a Jade Wizard with a Lore of Life with Earth Blood, could get a nice heal in. So what I'm doing here is I'm pulling all my Demigryphs to this part of the battlefield under the Lord so that we can get maximum heal on our Lords and on Boris and on my Demigryphs. And with that heal, we're going to be getting a lot of stronger troops. Now, Earth Blood, of course, has its limits. There's the regen cap, and I believe Boris is already at the regen cap, so he won't be getting any more health back. But Karl Franz and the Demigryphs especially, because their high HP per model will mean that they'll be able to, of course, life magic doesn't resurrect models, it only heals them. So it's great on stuff like Demigryphs that have high HP per model. When they're not dead, it'll bring them back to much fuller health. And so that was a pretty big deal. Those Ungors want none of that. They're going to run away pretty much instantly as they try to cross the bridge. And nice out of Amontok on what looks like a Bray Shaman and some Minotaurs. And what I was trying to do here was prevent the Minotaurs from getting their charge bonus off and then follow it up with a Greatsword. Unfortunately, Greatswords are kind of slow because they're infantry. And you can see they're moving very slowly right now. Moving forward, getting ready to charge. But it wasn't actually that nice in the end of Amontok. The idea was good, the execution was a little bit weak, and the Minotaurs are going to punish that pretty heavily. I wanted to prevent exactly that. I wanted to prevent the Minotaurs from getting their charge bonus off, which is a big component of their damage, so I could then charge with the Greatswords. Unfortunately, the timing just didn't work out, and my Greatswords are going to get beaten to hell in this melee. But the Demigryph Knights, the Royal Altdorf Griffites, and Karl Franz are mobilizing and landing on the top of those forces, and with the terror that's about to set in on those very low HP units, could cause some routing in that scrum. Nothing really over here, although Kholek and the remnants of the Chaos Undivided troops are now getting ready to cross the bridge. But no melee going on over on that side yet. And the Gore Herd and the Ungors are starting to waver, but here comes the big invasion force now. Everything is starting to get committed. Archaon the Everchosen running across the bridge kind of funnily. They need to work on that running animation a little bit. He looks a little bit goofy there. He doesn't look like the Herald of Chaos or the forces of destruction that you would expect from him. He looks a little bit goofy there, but either way, he is scary in melee. He is going to do a lot of damage once he closes in, and those Tatter Souls and my Great Swords probably not going to have a great time once he wades into melee. My steam tank still firing into the best gores, and the Chaos Knights and everything is pouring across the breach now, getting ready to engage the Great Swords, and Morghur the Shadowgave is in there as well. What is that? That is a Comet of Cassandora from above. The sky about to open up and rain down more hell on Archaon the Everchosen and his forces. Boom! Right into the middle of those troops, doing a lot of damage there. And banishment on the other side going off. So these vortexes and these bombardment spells that you don't get to see very often being utilized pretty effectively in these choke points, because a normal land battle map simply can't utilize these kind of choke points. But in a siege battle like this custom map, that's where they can actually shine a little bit better. They've made a pretty big impact on the game so far. Kholek chasing after some of these the handgunners, and they are going to get terrified and run the other way. Why are you running that way? That was the worst thing you could have done. Right into the jaws of Kholek and Starcrusher, who will paint the houses red with their blood. Man, that was brutal. You guys could have just kept running the other way and you would have been fine. But instead, they're going to run right back into the clutches of Kholek. But here comes the steam tank and some demigross after the net of Amantok, which is holding down everything. And that's been overcast. I think that might be one of my last net of Amantoks in the game. I've used that spell a lot this game and purposely avoided using the overcharge version because it's much more expensive. But it has tied them down for a long time and allowed my steam tank and demigrass to do a lot of damage to the front lines. There are some units getting terrified there. There is some routing. Balance bar still even, and Chaos and Beastmen have poured across this bridge, and they have slaughtered the Great Swords that tried to hold down the line here. Tatter Souls are still alive, but getting jibbed and gored on the horns of those Gorbuls and Minotaurs. Cannon getting ready to turn and fire on them. Handgunners firing onto the other bridge, and Kholek is at 1 HP. He got away with 1 HP and will be looking to come back sometime, maybe get back into the fight. Demigriff Knights charging headlong into the Chaos Knights, backed up by a steam tank, and this is a final assault here. Everything getting committed into melee, even the steam tank with its terror-causing armor-plated beastness going into melee here, and the Chaos Knights, Ungor Herd, and everything else, one more net of Amantok for good measure. Hold everything down while the demigriffs kill the Chaos Spawn, who are isolated. Will that be enough? Archaon, oh, nice shots from the handgunners. Beautiful into those routing Chaos Knights. Don't think we'll be seeing them again. Volkmar pushing back these Beastmen troops on the bridge, who are running, trying to get away from the demigriffs. Things are looking okay, but it could still go either way. There's lots of wavering and routing on both sides. There are still a lot of Beastmen and Chaos troops. Khazrak the One-Eye and his Bray Shaman on the Razor Gore Chariot pulling around the flank. And the Chosen have made it in to melee. These flagellants are getting torn up. Great Swords as well. Will they be able to hold here? That's going to be a tough fight. But Khazrak at the port, the Reichsport, are pulling through a bunch of these crossbowmen. And this is the nightmare for those Midland crossbows. Khazrak the One-Eye and his Razor Gore Chariot pulling through, and they are going to rout. And I don't expect them to come back as Khazrak mercilessly plows through them. Eviscerates. Oh man, Bray Shaman coming in from the other side. Two Razor Gore Chariots making their lives miserable, and soon they will be completely dead. Archaon. Oh, another banishment going off. Archaon and the Chaos Knights still in the fight. Those Chaos Knights do not want to be going through the vortex. Minotaur getting sent flying by the steam tank. That's always hilarious to see. And Demigriffs and the Minotaurs deep into melee. Who will pull this one out? The Gorbul is still in there to anchor the line, and Archaon with his morale buffs and immune to psychology will be a big factor against the terror that's caused by that steam tank. Could go either way, but here comes the Bray Shaman and Khazrak the One-Eye. Two chariots about to roar into the flank of these great swords who are not ready for this. They are not ready for those Razor Gores. Oh man, punishing charge, knocking them across the ground like bowling pins. Beautiful And the fate of Altdorf still hangs in the balance. If Midland and Reichland falter here, the crown jewel of the Empire will fall into the hands of Chaos, and they will lose their Supreme Patriarch, who fell at the gate of the Reichswort to some Minotaurs, their Emperor, their second most powerful Elector Count, and their religious leader, the Grand Theogonist. Gorbul trying to bring down Volkmar the Grim, cannons and handgunners still firing in, and Archaon, Khazrak, and Morghur could put the final nail in the coffin of the Empire here. But Faith, Steel, and Gunpowder are anchoring their defense. Boris and Karl Franz, on Deathclaw, fighting 1v1 with Archaon the Everchosen. Here comes a Minotaur who will drop to the lance of a Reichsguard. And things are shifting. Things are starting to shift in the Empire's favor. Can these Razor Gore Chariots do enough to turn this back in the Brayherd's favor? I don't know, but they're doing so much damage here. They're not even pulling through, and they're still jibbing and eviscerating everything in sight. Look at that. That is so cool looking. And Khazrak and his Razor Gore are just laying waste to the Empire forces over here. The handgunners firing in, and they should not have done that. They should not have attracted the attention of these troops. Oh my god. Punishing charge, gutting them, just slamming them into the earth. And that is a dead Empire handgunner unit. But is it enough? So few of the Empire are left, but they have Archaon surrounded. Demigurfs are still in there. Karl Franz, Boris Todbringer, Steam Tank, and Volkmar the Grim are all still alive. And it looks like a Gorbul is pretty much all that is left over here. Archaon has routed. Gorbul making his last stand. And it looks like the Empire forces are in the ascendancy after a long and hard-fought battle. Archaon is gonna go down, and the Empire will pull this one out, but barely. They have almost nothing left. Took so many losses, and the army losses penalty is gonna kick in and send the Bray Shaman and Khazrak the One-Eye running to fight another day. Altdorf will stand, and the Empire defenders will survive for now, but the majority of them lost their lives. The Supreme Patriarch of the Colleges of Magic lost his life, and that is a tough, bitter pill to swallow. Volkmar did a lot of work that battle with his banishments. They got a surprising amount of kills. I think the first one in that big blob of Chaos Warriors got around 50 or 60 kills by itself. You can see Malfunction's Chaos Knights made a big impact, each over 120, so they got a lot of kills there. The forces over at the Imperial Palace held out for a very long time. Ellie's artillery did a great job, and as we shift down the line, you can see the Beastmen forces, their Bestigors did okay. Khazrak and his Bray Shaman, tons of kills, each almost over 200. Gorbul did his best, and Balthasar Gelt tried to hold it down. He made a decent impact on the game, I guess, but he died in melee very easily when he got committed. Kholek Suneater, almost 300 kills. Chaos Knights doing okay. Feral Manticores did all right as well. Those steam tanks were a big factor in this game for sure. The terror they caused and their extreme tankiness, there's no other really way to say it, was definitely a big factor. But really close game on both sides. Boris Todbringer over 200 kills. Everyone got a chance to shine in that battle. Rio's forces, Morghur did okay. His Bray Shaman got a lot of kills as well. His Bestigors waded through combat, cutting stuff apart. So really fun battle. Hope you guys enjoyed that Siege of Altdorf. Really amazing map by BennyMCL, and I will be bringing you some more content very soon. See you guys next time.